Jesus, of course, is a central figure of Christianity since he's viewed as divine. However, although not seen in the exact same light as the Christian view, Jesus is still a very important figure in the Islamic faith. Welcome back to another episode of FTD Facts. My name is Leroy Kenton, and in this episode, I'm bringing you 10 surprising and interesting facts about Jesus inside of the religion of Islam. Starting off at number 10. So as you look throughout the Quran, Jesus is identified as a prophet of God, and he was sent to the Jews who had over time believed to have deviated from the teachings of Moses as well as other prophets. There's a time also when Jesus said, "Children of Israel, I am the messenger of God sent to you confirming the Torah which came before." And that's in the Quran, Surah 61, verse 6. Jesus is believed to be the last in line of the Jewish prophets, and he lived according to the Torah, which is the law of Moses, as well as he taught his followers to do the same. Also, the next thing to note is that the Prophet Muhammad is only mentioned a total of 4 times in the Quran, while Jesus, however, is mentioned 25 times by name. Not a lot of people know that. Now, while Jesus is recognized as the Son of God in the Bible, the Quran, however, uses other titles for Jesus, but it doesn't use the term Son of God. It uses titles like the Messenger of God, the Word of God, Son of Mary. Even at one point, it uses the term the Spirit from God. Now, on top of that, Jesus is referred more than any other person in the Quran next to Moses, but not all mentions are by name. Instead, some of these references just use a term like Messiah and Son of Mary and things like that. Another popular Muslim view is that out of all the prophets and messengers of God, Jesus is the only messenger who received the title of Messiah. And that's also found in the Quran. Now, the term can be translated as the Anointed One, and the phrase in Arabic, Al-Masih, also refers to the role of Jesus in the end times in Islam. But most of the information about Jesus' role in the end times is found in the Hadith, which are the records of Islamic traditions and sayings of the Prophet Muhammad, and not actually in the Quran itself. Now, the next thing to note is that not just Christians believe that Jesus was born of a virgin. So when you go back to the birth of Jesus, Muslims believe that Jesus was born of the Virgin Mary in a miraculous birth, which was a miracle by God. It's also interesting to note that inside of the Quran, Jesus actually talks while he's in a cradle, like as a baby. It says this, "Then she," Mary, "pointed to him and they said, 'How can we talk to one who is a child in the cradle?' He," Jesus, "said, 'Verily, I am a slave of God. He has given me the scriptures and made me a prophet.'" And that's in Quran Surah 19, verses 29 to 30. Now, I don't know about you guys, but prophet or not, sign from God or not, miracle or not, I don't care. If I see a talking baby, it's a wrap. Like, I'm gone, guys. Also, Jesus is known for performing many miracles, not just talking in a cradle. The Quran says in Surah 5, verses 110, "Behold, I taught you the book and wisdom, the law and the gospel. And behold, you make out of clay, as it were, the figure of a bird by my leave. And you breathe into it, and it becomes a bird by my leave. And you heal those born blind and the lepers by my leave. And behold, you bring forth the dead by my leave." So those are multiple miracles that Jesus was able to perform according to the Quran. Now let's talk about Jesus in the end times according to popular Muslim belief. So in the end times, Jesus is actually going to declare Islam to be the true religion, and all of the Christians will convert at the time. So all other religions will be eliminated, but the earth is going to experience peace. Like, even the animal kingdom is going to experience peace. Crops and wildlife and everything is just going to be super flourishing. And for this time period, there's going to be no wars. It's just going to be complete peace. However, this reign of Jesus is believed to just last only 40 years. And during that time, he'll go to Mecca regularly to perform the pilgrimage. It's also believed that he's going to have children and then eventually pass away and buried in Medina next to the Prophet Muhammad. Now, again, that's not the blanket belief of the Muslims. It's just based on a popular school of thought. All right, 2 more facts left. The Prophet Muhammad is often seen by non-Muslims as the equivalent to Jesus when you compare it to Christianity. However, according to the Quran, Muslims believe that Jesus is not greater or better than the Prophet Muhammad, and also that the Prophet Muhammad isn't greater or better than Jesus. As a matter of fact, no prophet is greater than any other prophet. They're just prophets that God sent to fulfill a certain purpose, and that's pretty much it. And the final thing is, when we look at the crucifixion of Jesus, Muslims believe, according to the Quran, that Jesus was not crucified. Rather, it appeared that he was crucified, and that instead of being buried, he was actually actually taken up from the cross and God brought him to heaven. Now, the Quran doesn't necessarily explain who that person was that was actually crucified that looked like Jesus. They believe that it appeared to be Jesus, but there's no real detail about who that other person was. You can find this in the Quran in Surah 4 verses 157. It said, they did not kill him, nor did they crucify him, but another was made to resemble him to them. And also it says in Surah 4 verses 158, God lifted him up to his presence. God is almighty, all wise. All right, guys, so that was a brief look at Jesus in Islam. As always, I want to hear from you. Let me know your thoughts and comments if any of your views are a little bit different. I know in these episodes, we don't necessarily cover every single school of thought when it comes to religious facts. So I'm always interested to see what you guys have to say. It's always a great conversation to learn from each other. I also take requests on this channel. So if you have any suggestions for future FTD Facts episodes, leave those down below and I'll do my best to work on them as quickly as possible. Now, before you guys get out of here, here's another video that you'll definitely love. Just tap the annotation. It'll take you straight to it. Also, my social media links are below in the video description. If you want to keep up with what I'm doing, those links are below. And just go ahead and subscribe as well and hit that bell notification if you haven't done so already to join the FTD Facts family. And that way you'll keep up to date with our daily episodes. Okay, guys, I can't wait to see you in the next episode. I'm actually going to go work on that now. So I'll see you soon.